Datalogging with Red Lion Workbench in the 6-track RTU is a powerful way to store data records over a long period of time for analysis. Your program can trigger records based on events you define for your application. We'll show you how to set up users and enable FTP and SSH in the RTU. Then we'll create a program to set up datalogging. Finally, we'll read the datalog records from the RTU. Before we start, install the 6net I/O toolkit and Red Lion Workbench. Configure the RTU's IP address in the toolkit and add variables in the Red Lion Workbench program. Are you ready to start? First, we'll show you how to set up users and enable FTP and SSH. Open your configuration for the RTU by clicking the Dialog button. Go to the Ports tab, double-click on the Network 1 configuration. Click the Advanced button. Check the FTP and SSH checkboxes to enable those protocols. Click on the Configure Users button. Check the Enable User Authentication checkbox. Uncheck all the permission options for the anonymous user. Click on the Add User button. Type in the username and password. Enable permissions for the new user. Save your changes and load the configuration to the RTU. Next, we'll create a new program to set up datalogging. Open the Red Lion Workbench and the project created earlier. Right-click on the Programs folder and select Insert New Program. This will create a new POU. Enter the program name, description, and language. Execution style defines when the program is called. Main programs can be called every cycle or less frequently as defined by the user. Subprograms are called by other programs. User-defined function blocks are custom functions that can be used in other programs. Double-click on the new program to open it. In the Blocks window, open the Clock folder. There are several options for gathering current time. In this case, we will use the DayTime function block. Drag and drop the function block into the main editor. Add the logfile CSV function block by going to the Files folder. This function block will create a CSV file to store the data log records. Add the setCSVOPT block. This defines how variables are separated and decimal points are formatted. To set up the list of variables to be included in each data record, we will feed a spy list into the list input of the logfile CSV block. From the Advanced folder, add the VLID function block. Every rising edge Boolean signal going into the log input on the logfile CSV function block will create a new data record. The rising edge can be triggered any number of ways, but now we will use a blink function to trigger a log every second. Go to the timers to find the blink function. Connect the output of blink and VLID blocks to the logfile CSV block. Create variables and add inputs to all function blocks. A one value on the input of the daytime block will select hour, minutes, second formatted time. Create a timestamp variable. Create a variable to enable the blink function block. Enter T#1s to cycle the output of the blink block every second. Create a variable to reset the dialog file, clearing all records. Enter the name of the watch list containing the variables to log. The name must include the .spl extension and be surrounded by single quotes. In this case, the watch list is newspy.spl. Enter the path and file name in the RTU where the datalog records will be stored. The path in this case is the single quotes /NVRAM/datalog directory. This is the path for storing on high-speed battery-backed RAM. Battery-backed RAM is suitable for logging at any rate, including 1 second or faster. For data logging at 1 second or slower, you can optionally log directly to flash by using the single quotes /home/datalog directory. Enter variables for the status output of log file CSV and set CSVOPT blocks. These can give some diagnostic status of the data logging. In the SEP input, enter single quotes, comma, single quotes, or single quotes, semicolon, single quotes, to set what character separates the variables in the CSV file. Set single quotes, period, single quotes for the DEC input to set the character used as a decimal point. Open the watch list. Drag and drop the timestamp variable we created so it will be included in the log. Compile the program and download to the RTU. Now, let's read the data log records from the RTU. First, we will start data logging by enabling the blink function. Now, the records will be created in the CSV file on the RTU. Now we will read the data records from the RTU. There are a few options to read the data records. One option is to use File Operations in the toolkit. Click on the Operations menu, then File Operations. From there, simply navigate to the appropriate directory and read the file and save it to your computer. If you need a quick view of the data records or just want to verify the data is getting saved correctly, you can view the data in a terminal by using SSH. Open up an SSH terminal. Define the IP address and SSH options. Enter your username and password. In the terminal, use the cat command to display the contents of the CSV file. Another option is FTP. Using an FTP client like FileZilla, enter the RTU's IP address, username, and password. Once connected, navigate to the datalog file and transfer the CSV file to your computer. Store data records on the 6-track RTU using Red Lion Workbench. For more help, go to support.redlion.net.